Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back to the IBFP, where we tell you the truth, even if you don't want to hear it. DAZN approves garbage truck juice fight. Gabe Rosado and Danny Jacobs. Let's break it down. According to Michael Benson and BoxingScene.com, the launch of DAZN UK is reportedly set to happen in the next couple of months. It's claimed that Danny Jacobs versus Gabe Rosado is agreed for. On November 27th, it will be broadcast by DAZN in the UK. DAZN has initially wanted John Ryder as a UK opponent. Obviously, they would have wanted John Ryder, not just because he helps in the UK, but also it brings much more intrigue to the fight. It makes people in the US and UK want to watch. Why? Because it would be a much more competitive fight. People felt like John Ryder beat Callum Smith. And so at the end of the day, you would like to see two guys at the top level fight for it, and then a winner fights a champion that's on DAZN, like, you know, Callum Smith or Billy Joe Saunders. These are the fights that you use to grow your platform. DAZN did not stand in Danny Jacobs' way to make this fight with Gabe Rosado. They didn't stand in his way. They didn't try to block it. They recommended John Ryder, but when Danny Jacobs insisted on Gabe Rosado, they did nothing to stop this cherry pick from happening. And that's what it is. It's an obvious cherry pick. A lot of people don't seem to understand. They say, well, Danny Jacobs is with Matchroom, not DAZN. No, moron. DAZN gave Eddie Hearn millions of dollars to play with to go sign athletes exclusively to Matchroom DAZN platform. Therefore, DAZN is paying all of these guys indirectly. We got to be real about the situation. And at the end of the day, this fight does nothing for Danny Jacobs or the DAZN platform. And let me explain to you why. What is the point of this fight when Danny Jacobs has moved up to super middleweight and he could have been facing one of the champions or a top contender, but instead this guy is facing a washed out middleweight? It makes no sense. Why face a washed out middleweight when you could have been facing a champion or a top contender at super middleweight? What was the point of moving up if you're going to bum bash at a higher weight class? It doesn't make any sense. And let me explain to you how bad this mismatch is. I mean, this is a Gabe Rosado who's already lost three of his last six fights. This a guy with like 14 losses. This fight makes no sense. Gabe Rosado brings nothing significant to the challenge. He brings no fan base, no intrigue. This is literally a pointless cherry pick fight that was approved by DAZN. And just in case you thought that this is the only type of fights DAZN are doing that are pointless, that are cherry picks, that makes no sense, no, they keep going. Look at a guy like Devin Haney versus Yuriorkis Gamboa. That fight announcement is imminent for November 7th, according to BoxingScene.com. Now, a lot of people saying, well, how is that a cherry pick? Devin Haney is a world champion. There's standards for world champions. So you're going to fight a guy coming off a knockout loss and an Achilles injury? And what kind of message does that send to your platform? You don't expect this to be a competitive fight. The guy's coming off a knockout loss and an Achilles injury. We don't even know how his body is going to react. And he's 40 years old. What is the point? A 40-year-old coming off an injury and a knockout loss is a competitive fight to DAZN? This is stupid. This is garbage truck juice. And let me explain to you why. You know, when you look at a guy like Canelo Alvarez refusing to cherry pick for DAZN, he didn't want to face a 47-year-old Oscar De La Hoya, Masvidal, or Khabib, which all three of these guys Canelo Alvarez would knock out in the first three rounds. No, Canelo Alvarez didn't want to take any of those cherry picks. See, DAZN wanted to cut Canelo Alvarez's purse, not because of the coronavirus, not because of COVID, not because of anything other than Canelo Alvarez refusing to cherry pick. They wanted Canelo to face a guy like De La Hoya, Masvidal, or Khabib, and then they would have gladly paid him his full purse. No, but when it comes to him wanting to face undefeated world champions in their prime like Callum Smith or Billy Joe Saunders, they wanted to cut his pay rate by more than half. That is garbage truck juice. Somebody needs to inform DAZN. This is not how you build a platform, by making cherry pick fights, big mismatches that bring no intrigue, because you don't build a platform off of one guy. You build a platform off of multiple people. You build a platform off of multiple, you know, weight classes, divisions, champions, contenders. You look at every fight. And if you're not hosting good, thorough, competitive fights, your platform is going to be set to fail. This is typical DAZN. Think about it. They wanted Canelo Alvarez to cherry pick De La Hoya, Khabib, or Masvidal, but they're also okay with Devin Haney cherry picking Gamboa, and they also approved Danny Jacobs cherry picking Gabe Rosado. This is bad business from DAZN, and I'm going to tell you the truth if no one else will. Once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP.